Y'all already know this your boy, aka Peter Bizzo, Life at Ricketts. That's what I'm talking about, y'all. Life at Ricketts. This dude been doing it real big all over the city. Big ups to him. But I'm with your boy, man. I'm with your boy, one of the baddest comedians. I watched this dude about 2-3 years ago come on the scene. I said, people always talk about, man, he ain't gonna be long. This dude come on the scene with fire. He been doing big old things, man. Y'all give some love to my boy, Shotty Feel Good. What's up, Shotty Feel Good, baby?
What's happening, baby?
You already know, man. Say, bro, I just heard about you just open up for Yolanda Adams, bro. Tell me about that.
Yeah, man. Well, you know, most comedians, you know what I'm saying, they find it hard to go from doing things in a club to doing religious, gospel, whatever. Right. You know, I mean, I'm versatile. You know, I could do it whatever way they got to be done. You know what I'm saying? Right. I can do it for the Caucasians, like I do it for the blacks. I do it for the Japs.
Right.
I do it for everybody, baby. I put it down.
Y'all heard that? This dude did a show. So basically, you telling me that show had to be, you had to do clean comedy.
Yeah, all clean comedy, no cursing. I put it down real big, you know. Yolanda Adams, you know, she was a blessing. She came through, you know what I'm saying? It's like one of the best voices this side of heaven.
Wow.
You know, they had some other big names on the show. Dietrich Haddon.
Mm-hmm.
Was the lady one, Sunday's Best. I forget her name.
Right, you
know?
Right.
You know, she did her thing too, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it was just a real good experience for me, you know. I usually do it in the church, but that was my first time really doing something on a major level.
Right.
For a gospel event, you mm-hmm. know. And so, you know, it turned out real good, you know. So, I mean, if all good law, good sense, right. Sam, you know what I'm saying, I might be doing gospel comedy.
Wow. You know? Wow, and it's good to be versatile, man. Not just to be able to do dirty climb, but you can do clean. So they could call you for basically anything.
And you call me... Like I said, I'll be at a funeral just like I'll be at a kid's party.
Right.
I do it all.
Wow, man, that's amazing because like you set yourself from the other comedians who only could do one type of comedy, cursing. And you know, you got a gossip. You know you had to be clean. Did you have to prepare yourself or it just came natural for you?
Well, when it comes down to doing clean comedy, it's kind of like talking to your mama.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? If you don't want to disrespect your mama, you know what I'm saying? When I look at that, I feel like I'm doing it for the Lord.
Wow.
I mean, like, we always doing it for the Lord, but I mean, this is like, you know, like I feel like you're in front of the Lord.
Right.
So, you know what I'm saying? I felt like I'm in front of the Lord. I gotta, you know, this is the Lord gave me this gift, so I gotta
represent for him.
Yeah,
right.
Represent for him. So, you know what I'm saying? That's pretty much how I did it. And so, you know what I'm saying? When I do clean comedy, it's just kind of like, you know, Lord, here I am.
Wow.
You know?
Said, man, we've been hearing your name, bro, over and over again. I heard some other big names you opened up for, too. Tell me how long you've been doing this and some old names that you've opened up for in this little short time you've been doing this, bro.
Well, I've been doing comedy for 3 years, actually. Today is my anniversary.
Wow.
I started doing
happy anniversary, man.
On Easter.
Wow.
Easter in 2008. Yeah, I started doing comedy April 2008.
And all the crap.
And
that was your first time. I remember that. And, I was there.
Yeah, we was on the show together.
Sure was.
And I done Monique, Cedric Entertainer, Tony Roberts. I've opened up for Lester Bibbs, Tyler Craig.
Wow.
In
3 years, all them people. Wow.
Yeah, Kelly Price.
That's a blessing, bro.
You know what I mean? I've been doing my thing, you know what I'm saying?
3 years, bro.
Trying to represent for New Orleans. I love my city. So, you know, I feel like we don't really have anybody to represent New Orleans. You know, they got big name comics from Atlanta, Detroit, Chicago, whatever, you know what I'm saying? I just won't be the representative for New Orleans, you know what
I'm
saying?
Man, you doing it, bro. You definitely doing it, man. You definitely doing it, bro. Hey, man, you keep doing your thing, man. Hey, bro, much love, bro. Like I said, bro, I see big things on you. Like I said, I've been hearing your name, man. Right. Y'all, we live at Ricketts, man, with your boy Shotty Feel Good, doing it real big in the city. We at H2O, y'all. This the Easter jam that y'all don't want to forget. I'm telling y'all, we doing it big, big in the N.O. It ain't going to stop. Live at Ricketts, your boy, a.k.a. Peter Bizzle with my dog, Shotty Feel Good.
Yeah, baby, shout out to Life at Ricketts, baby.
All
you already
right,
know
all
that
right.
It is Shotty Feel Good. You ain't never feel good till you Shotty Feel Good. We right here on Diamond, baby. We in the heart of the East. Life at Ricketts, baby. I see y'all.
H2 on the building, baby. Y'all already know. D.A.